Hey everyone, it's Neil Patel, and today I'm going to teach you how to optimize your on-page SEO in less than 10 minutes. So I want you to first head over to Ubersuggest.com or neilpatel.com/Ubersuggest, whatever one, and type in your domain name. So I'm going to type in neilpatel.com, and you're going to see a report load. This is typically your traffic analyzer report. This shows you your overall organic keywords, your monthly traffic, your domain score, your backlinks. If you have a newer website, you're probably not going to see any data here or even any rankings. But I'm not looking for you to look at this report or spend much time on it. Instead, I want you to go into the sidebar and under SEO Analyzer, click on Site Audit. Now, I've already ran my site, neilpatel.com. As you can see, it was ran recently. And you'll see an on-page SEO score. The higher this number, the better. It goes from 0 or 1 to 100. The organic monthly traffic, don't worry about this too much because as you get more traffic, your numbers go up. And as you optimize your site, your numbers will go up. Same with your organic keywords and your backlinks. As you can see here, I scanned 150 pages. The tool can scan literally up to 10,000 pages depending on what kind of account you have if you're on a premium account. And you'll see the health check of healthy pages, broken pages, have issues, redirects, blocked. There's some critical errors, some warnings, recommendations. The critical errors tend to be the ones you fix first. And then there's, of course, your site speed. Try to get into the green area for both of them. And if, you know, it'll tell you what issues you have. And if you're not sure what they are, just click on the question mark and it'll tell you where you have issues and try to fix them. And then it breaks down your top SEO issues in order. What I want you to do is scroll back up and look at your on-page SEO score. Typically, if you're 75 or 80 or better, you're doing a decent job. The reason I say that is most people are like, I want 100. Well, as you keep adding new content and as you keep making new changes to your website, you're also going to introduce SEO errors, which are fine. It's common. It's standard. But in general, if you're above like a 75, 80, you're doing a decent job. It's very rare that you get 100. And if you get 100, you're probably not pushing hard enough on your SEO and creating enough new pages, new content. Because if you're constantly creating new stuff, your site won't always be optimized. And that's okay. So I want you to scroll down to the critical errors first and click on it. When you click on it, you'll see all the pages that have issues. And whatever they may be, you can just hover over the what is this and how do I fix it and click on it. And it tells you what issues this is, right? So if you look at what is this for low word count, without enough text on a page, Google will have trouble understanding what the content is about. If Google doesn't know what the content is about, it won't be able to rank the content for the search terms you are targeting. By adding more text, you are telling Google's crawlers and your end users more about what it is you have to offer. Anything less than a few hundred words is considered thin content and will be nearly impossible to rank for. It doesn't mean it's impossible. I said nearly impossible because for some keywords like how to tie a tie, you don't need a lot of text. Some images, videos that explain how to do it is probably actually better than text. And on the right side, it goes over how do I fix it. Add more content to your page so that it isn't considered thin content and has a better chance of ranking. In general, the average web page that ranks on page one of Google contains 2,200 words. It doesn't mean that you need 2,200 words. This is just an average stat. Sometimes more is better, sometimes less. And overall, like I mentioned, it breaks down the errors. And I want you to start with critical errors because these are the most important. And it breaks down in order the difficulty and the impact. So that you want high impact, and of course you want to do the ones that are low difficulty. And Ubersuggest already breaks that down in order for you. So let's click on 34 pages with low word count. The reason I want to go through this example, and I'll go through some of the other errors, is with your website, you won't be able to fix every single SEO error. Like my about page has 64 words. I don't need my about page to have tons of words. Like if I load up my about page, who is Neil Patel? I have a video that explains who I am and then comments. And then as you scroll, you'll see the comments load, but there's actually quite a few comments. But in general, you know, not all my pages, like here's one on A/B testing. This is an A/B testing calculator. People don't want a lot of words. They just want to figure out, you know, which variation of their page when they're running an A/B test to see if which version converts better, is winning or losing. The point I'm trying to make is not all of your pages will be able to be solved when it comes to SEO issues, and that's okay. Solve the ones where it makes sense, especially when it comes to things like low word count. On pages like duplicate meta descriptions, I look at this, 13 duplicate descriptions, and this page, this is an international page, okay, may not need to fix it with Italy, that's okay. But there's some pages that have, like I look at this meta description, these three pages have duplicate meta descriptions, but this is German and this is Spanish. Technically, my team should have translated it to German and translated into Spanish, which would solve the duplicate issue. So I need to go and fix that. And I can just go down the list and I would do it for every single one. And I would just make sure they're all fixed. And as you fix them, what you'll find is by fixing all these little errors, you're going to rank higher and higher over time. In the short run, you may not rank where you want to, but if you make these changes month over month, you'll start slowly seeing traction, which is good. And again, as you're going through these errors and you're not sure which ones, what they mean or how to fix it, just click on what is this and how do I fix it? And for each error type, it'll break it down. And I just want you to go through them, all your SEO issues. And you want to first start with the critical errors. And then after you do those, then go to the warnings, because the warnings don't mean that you have to fix them. Sometimes it makes sense to fix them, sometimes it doesn't. Recommendations, the least important out of them, but start with critical errors, then warnings. And in general, when you're looking at your site audit report, after you go through it, you want to make sure you fix your critical errors and have that number as close as possible to zero. And you won't always be able to, because things like low word count for your about page or contact page, it doesn't make sense to have a lot of words. You want to make sure your site speed is in the green area. Talk to your developer. They can help you with it. Or if you want to do it yourself, you can hover over the question marks. It'll tell you what they mean. And then you will work on it. You can use things like CDNs. That's a content delivery network to speed up your site. You can use things like caching. You can do things like having lazy loads. Your images load as the page scrolls. And if you do that and you start improving your score, you'll notice that your rankings improve over time. Then the next thing you want to do is after you finish making those fixes, you want to go on the right side, load up this site audit report, go back to it. And what you want to do is hit the recrawl website. This will recrawl your website and double check that when you fix your errors, did you actually do them correctly? And it'll reanalyze your whole site. So for this purpose, I'll recrawl Neil Patel. It can take a while. I have a really big site, so sometimes it can take 10, 20 minutes because now it'll probably crawl over 1,000 pages. Or technically for me, it could actually crawl over 10,000 pages. So it may take a bit, but as it slowly starts loading, as it keeps crawling through my whole website, I'll see if I did a good job fixing them and I'll go and I'll continually improve. Now keep in mind the reason the crawler takes a while when you recrawl your website or even when you crawl it for the first time, we don't want to take our server, which, you know, we have a big server infrastructure, and hit your site too many times too quickly. Because if we do that, what'll happen is we can actually take your server down or create a poor experience for your other users. And as you can see, as it's crawling, you'll see this check pages, crawl pages, it went to 13, it was at 7, and it'll keep going up over time. And the goal is to just fix all your critical errors or get as close as possible to zero. So that's it. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below and I'll answer and try to help you out. If you need any help, you can always check out my agency, Neil Patel Digital, where we help companies grow. And of course, if you enjoyed the video and you liked it, please share it, tell other people about it, subscribe to the channel. Thank you very much.